May I invite those of us who are so able to stand, please? We assemble today, physically and virtually, to celebrate the life of Gurney Beckford, a man of faith, a family man, a friend, communication specialist who has served his world well. We come to stand in solidarity with his family and to bring our praises to God. The grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. I shall not fail you nor forsake you, says the Lord. Blessed are the sorrowful, they shall find consolation. The eternal God is our refuge, and underneath are the everlasting arms. Enter into Jerusalem.
Enter into Jerusalem, let us go to God's house. The healthy and the sick, with the worker, go to God's house. Enter into Jerusalem, let us go to God's house. Come and run with the wind, with the God who reigns in peace. Let us go to God's house, we go celebrate. We go celebrate, we go celebrate. O Israel, the name of the Lord on high, praise his name in song, praise the Lord with a heavenly song, with a heavenly song, with a heavenly song, praise the Lord.
Be seated, please.
Yet here we are. You know, Gurney always had a joke. He always said he didn't want to be cremated because it would be too hot. However, Pam would assure him that he certainly would not feel it. Let me say that the thing that makes me happy about this occasion, not sad, is time. I appreciate the time that God gave us with Gurney Beckford. There are so many things that could have taken him from us. Did you know that he was a survivor of the Kendall train crash? Yes, he survived that and many other threats and challenges to his life. He had a purpose which was laid out by God. There are many stories of Gurns, I call him Gurns, because that's where our relationship developed, and you will see that in the program as you read. But there are many stories of Gurns' humility, his generosity, and his loyalty. He had many lessons for us. The number of condolences, the number of persons celebrating his life online today are a testimony to his life and his purpose. After 48 years in his presence, I'll miss his wise counsel, the jokes, the lunches, and the road trips. One can learn from his friendships nurtured over the years, from his days at Howard, to his clients and colleagues in the advertising and marketing fields, his horse racing brothers and sisters, his friends throughout the US and the UK, and his boxing and Super Bowl crew. You know who you are. True friendship is enduring, forgiving, and supportive. And he embodied that. He has also taught me great humility. Yet never mistake Gurn's humility for weakness. Those who needed to learn that lesson learned it well. However, there's one lesson that has stuck with me, and this I share with you. Do not be afraid of death, but recognize that it must come. Therefore, we must treasure our loved ones and savor the good times while we can. Don't dwell on strife, but forgive and move on. If you loved my father, heed this lesson and live it in his honor. Thank you.
What I understand better now that my daddy has died. One, cultivate friendships. Don't take them for granted. My father had many friends in high and low places because he truly lived by these words. No man is an island. No man is an island. No man stands alone. Each man's joy is joy to me. Each man's grief is my own. We need one another. Wallow in self-pity and despair. Seek solutions. Solutions, solutions, solutions. That was Daddy's mantra. I have a big problem. My father is dead. How do I go on? Because he lives. Because he lives, I can face tomorrow. Understand love even more now. Love and its varied characteristics. My daddy loved to learn. My daddy loved to be spontaneous and have fun. My daddy loved to eat good food and drink good drinks, good spirits, a white every now and then, and a nice glass of red wine. My daddy loved to party, and man did he like a joke, but guess what? He even loved more making others laugh. But most of all, my daddy loved his mother. He loved his grandmother and the entire Parkinson family and its extensions. He loved my mummy, his wife. They knew each other for 60 years. They were married for 57. My daddy loved me, and my daddy loved my brother. My daddy loved his grandsons. But guess what? My daddy loved himself. And most importantly, and definitely, he loved God. Daddy, I will miss you. But guess what Father Ho Long said? And I know that we will rise again, again. And I know we'll die but rise again. I know he is the living yeast of life, and I know that life will rise again. So sleep on, Daddy. Rest in the eternal arms of the Lord until we see each other again. Goodbye, sweet Daddy. Goodbye. He lives, he lives. He lives, I know that my Redeemer lives. He lives, he lives, he lives within my heart. Amen.
A reading from the book of Romans. We know that all things work for good for those who love God, who are called according to his purpose. For those he foreknew, he also predestined to be conformed to the image of his Son, so that he might be the firstborn among many brothers. And those he predestined, he also called. And those he called, he also justified. And those he justified, he also glorified. What then shall we say to this? If God is for us, who can be against us? He who did not spare his own Son, but handed over for us all, how will he not also give us everything else along with him? Who will bring a charge against God's chosen ones? It is God who acquits us. Who will condemn? It is Christ who died, rather was raised, who also is at the right hand of God, who indeed intercedes for us.
What will separate us from the love of Christ? Will anguish, distress, or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or peril, or the sword? As it is written, for your sake we are being slain all the day. We are looked upon as sheep to be slaughtered. No, in all these things we conquer overwhelmingly through him who loved us. For I am concerned that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor present things, nor future things, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
My shepherd, I don't want. He makes me down to lie in pastures green. He leadeth me the quiet waters by. My soul and have restored again, and me to walk thou may within the path of righteousness. In form his name's sake. Yea, though I walk in death's dark vale, yet will I fear no ill. Thy rod and staff, they are with me, they surely comfort still. My table, oh, has furnished in the presence of my foes. My head, thine arms, anoint with oil, my cup it overflow. Goodness and mercy all my life shall surely follow me, and in God's house forevermore my dwelling place must be. And mercy all my life shall surely follow me, and in God's house forevermore my dwelling place must be. Do 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 do. Holy, holy, holy. Do 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 do.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the blessed Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. Change. They say it's the only constant in life. With the elapse of time, seasons change. Life is always changing. Now, some changes are gradual and transitional, like sending your child through school. But some other changes are sudden, unsettling, immediate. And the question is, how do you respond when your emotional resources seem insufficient to manage a change? Upon which skilled navigator do you lean to help you traverse the highs and the lows of the terrain of change? Have you ever asked those questions as you face the changes in your life? Maybe these are the questions of Gurney's family today. With him not being here, life has changed. And these are questions that David answers in Psalm 23. No other psalm adequately captures the waves of change. At one moment, you're by the verdant meadows feasting on the lush delicacies of life's experiences. At one moment, you are beside the cool, calming pool of life's good times. And then the doctor's report comes. The papers from the divorce court come. And you find yourself in the valley of the shadow of disease and disillusionment, discouragement, distress, the valley of the shadow of death. You know, change reveals how vulnerable we are in this life. And such is the nature of life that we are either in a storm, about to enter a storm, or just coming out of a storm. But David gives us some assurance for the stormy changes of life. He reminds us that we have a dedicated shepherd who knows the way we take. Our shepherd walks the uplands of laughter with us and gently carries us across the dales of quiet rest. But it is in the deep ravines of fear and tears and pain that he makes his presence truly felt. David would have us understand that God, our shepherd, does not flinch when the wolves of doubt attack. He doesn't abandon his sheep in the darkness of times. No, he stands with us so that we are able to say, God is my refuge and strength, a very present help in every season of trouble. Yes, the mountains of life's experiences are quaking, the waters of change are foaming, but our dedicated shepherd says to us, be still and know that I am God. My love for you is boundless and strong. My faithfulness is steadfast. My character is unimpeachable. What a thought. I think the one word from this psalm which means a lot to me is the word my. The Lord is my shepherd. Don't you sense the near, up close, and personal relationship that the sheep has with the shepherd? It is one of compassion and care, where goodness and mercy are daily features of the walk with the shepherd. My friends, that is the relationship that God desires to have with each of us, where we trust him implicitly. A relationship where we can truly believe that because he has carved us on the palm of his hands, according to Isaiah 49:16, then he is working his purposes out in every scene and season of change that we experience. Now, sometimes it is hard to see the fingers of God at work in the messy situations of our lives. But we must remember that as shepherd, he knows how the story will end. All he asks is that we trust him. He knows where the journey will end. All he asks is that we trust him. He knows us how to bring us to the journey's end. All he asks is that we trust him. Instead of being distressed about the journey of change, just trust him. Jesus put it this way: do not let your hearts be troubled. You believe in God? Believe also in me. My Father's house has many rooms. If that were not so, would I have told you that I am going there to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back and take you to be with me, so that you may be where I am. You know the way to the place I am going. I am the way, truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. Listen, my friend, it is our shepherd's plan to take all his sheep safely across the valley of life's changes. What of greater importance than the transient temporal changes within this life is the change from this life to the life after death. Thankfully, our shepherd is eternal. He knows the terrain. He knows the distance. He knows how to protect. He knows how to provide. He is the way. His dedicated presence will see to it that we make it to the other side, so that like David and Gurney, we may close our eyes in confidence and say, "And I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever." Rest eternal. Grant unto Gurney Beckford, and may your eternal light shine on him. Amen. Let us pray. Holy God, in you we live and move and have our being. All our times are in your hands, and so we offer to you the past. We are grateful for the memories of Gurney that will sustain us, even if they bring us tears. We thank you for the good things shared with him and for the times of contentment and affection. We thank you for his resilient and cheerful spirit, his moral uprightness which was felt in all his interactions. We offer to you the present. You are at work in the duties that demand our attention, in the responsibilities that will not go away, in the kindly words of friends, in the sympathy and the loyalty of colleagues. We pray for grace to recognize that these are your channels of mercy and to receive them as your gifts of kindness and love. Lord, we offer to you the future. It is changed because Gurney is no longer with us, and we do feel uncertain and diminished, but we know that you will not fail us. Comfort Mavis, comfort Andrea, comfort Gavin and the extended family. Be with Gurney's friends. Flood their paths with light. Turn our eyes to where the skies are full of resurrection promises. Tune our hearts to the brave music of heavenly assurance. Give us the sense of comradeship with heroes and saints of every age. And so quicken our spirits that we may be able to encourage the souls of all who journey with us on this road of life. To you be all honor, glory, and praise. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord and our Savior. Amen.
Last night I lay a-sleeping, there came a dream so fair. I stood in old Jerusalem, beside the temple there. I heard the children singing, and ever as they sang, methought the voice of angels from heaven in answer rang. Methought the voice of angels from heaven in answer rang. Jerusalem, Jerusalem, lift up your gates and sing Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna to your
dream was changed, the streets no longer rung. Hush were the glad Hosanna, the little children sung. The sun grew dark with mystery, the morn was cold and chill, as a shadow of a cross arose upon a lonely hill.
As a shadow of a cross arose upon a lonely hill. Jerusalem, Jerusalem, hark how the angels sing Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna to your Once again, the scene was changed. New earth there seemed to be. I saw the holy city beside the tideless sea. The light of God was on its streets. The gates were open wide.
And no one was denied.
No need of moon or stars by night, or sun to shine by day. It was the new Jerusalem that would not pass away. It was the new Jerusalem that would not pass away. Jerusalem, Jerusalem, sing, for the night is o'er. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna forevermore. Hosanna in the forevermore.
Lord Jesus Christ, by your own 3 days in the tomb, you hallowed the resting places of all who believe in you and made the grave and any niche a sign of hope, even as it claims our mortal remains. We pray that our brother Gurney will rest here in peace until you awaken him to glory, where he shall see you face to face and know the light and splendor of God forever and ever. Amen. We bless the resting place of Gurney in the name of the Father, Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Softly and tenderly, Jesus is calling,
calling for you and for me. See at the He's waiting and watching for you and for me. Come home, come home. Ye who are weary, come home.
Himself, we commit his remains to the deep, for we are dust, and unto dust we shall return. But the Lord Jesus Christ will claim our mortal bodies to be like his in glory, for he is the firstborn from the dead, and in him is life itself, and by the power of his resurrection we may enjoy life beyond death, and forevermore peace within his arms. We make our prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Because God has called Gurney to himself, through his love he was bound to his fellow persons and family and friends on earth. Through his faith, may he be bound to your angels in heaven, as you call him to the heavenly city, the new Jerusalem, in which we will enjoy forever peace and love. Amen.
Amen.
Let us continue to pray for the coming of God's kingdom as we say the prayer that Jesus himself taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in all our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be free from all sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, ever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessings. May the peace and love of God, which is beyond all understanding, keep you and remain with you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
Oh, when the saints go marching in, oh, when the saints go marching in, oh, Lord, I want to be in that number. When the saints go marching in, oh, when the saints, oh, when the saints
go marching in,
go marching in, oh, when the saints go marching in, oh, Lord, I want to be in the number. Oh, when the saints go marching in. Some glad morning when this life is over, I'll fly away to on God's celestial shore. I'll fly away. Oh, I'll fly away. Oh, glory. Hallelujah, by and by, I'll fly away.
Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great.
Is mine. Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine. heir of salvation, purchase of God, born of his spirit, washed in his blood. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long.
Perfect, non-perfect divine, vision of rapture now burst on my sight. Angels descending, breath from above, echoes of mercy, whispers of love. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long.
Perfect submission,
all is at rest. I in my Savior am happy and blessed,
watching and waiting,
looking above, filled with his goodness, lost in his love.
This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long.
This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior.